My name is Jamila Bhanpurawala. I teach mathematics and today I'm here to deliver a demo lecture for class 9th algebra chapter number 3 polynomials. Now as you can see I have already written what is a polynomial. A polynomial is an expression that consists of variables, terms, exponents and constant. I know all these are very heavy words. Variables, terms, exponents and constants. So let us make it very easy by giving you an example. So I'm writing down an example over here. 5x cube plus 2x square y square plus 7x plus 1. Now as you can see over here, there are numbers and there are small letter alphabets too in this example. Now over here, any small alphabet from A to Z, any small alphabet from A to Z you can state it as variable. Now as you can see in this example, I have X over here X and Y, again over here X. So these are my small alphabets from A to Z. So these alphabets are my variables. Now coming to terms. How many terms are there over here? As you can see, 1, 2, 3 and 4 terms are there over here. So I have made myself very clear. Variables, X and Y are variables over here, which are the small alphabets from A to Z. Terms, there are 4 over here, 1, 2, 3 and 4. Now coming to exponent. What do you mean by exponents? Exponent, in an easy language or in an easy word, you can say it as degree or index or power. Now as you know, you must have studied in your previous standards. What are degree? Degree are this, can you see 3 over here? This cube, x degree is 3 over here. Over here x degree is 2, y degree is 2. Over here x, nothing is given, so we assume it as 1. So these are my degree, index or power, and it is also known as exponents. So over here x degree is 3, here x degree is 2, y degree is 2, here x degree is 1. So you can say it as degree, index or power, or you can say it as exponents. Now coming to constant word. What is constant? Now as you can see over here, this number 1 is alone itself. It doesn't have any variable over here. So if it doesn't have any variable, we state it as constant polynomial. Now over here, when you don't have any variable, you can write variable x as x over here. But you have to mention it that the degree is 0 over here, because if you don't write anything, then it is assumed as 1. And 1 is a degree itself. And this doesn't have any degree, so we assume it as a non-zero constant polynomial. So as we have covered everything, variables, terms, exponents and constant. Here variables are x and y, terms 1, 2, 3, 4, exponents are 3, 2, 2, over here 1, over here 0, and constant polynomial is 1 over here. Now moving further, before that, let me explain you what are the degree of a polynomial in a bit detail. Now we are taking another example. Let us take 5x square plus 3x. Now as you can see, your x degree is 2 and your x degree is 1. So when they ask you a question, what is the degree of a polynomial? So you have 2 also and you have 1 also. But the degree of the polynomial is the highest degree of the polynomial. As you can see, 2 is highest over here. So 2 is the highest degree of polynomial. Now let us take another example. 5x plus 3x square y square plus 2x. Now here you can see x degree is 1, here x degree is 2, y degree is 2, here x degree is 1. So we will be calculating the highest degree of polynomial over here. Here the highest sum of power or degree for the term 3x square y square is, the highest degree of the highest degree of sum of power for the term 3x square y square is 2 plus 2 is equals to 4. So here the highest degree of polynomial is not 2, instead it is 2 plus 2, 4. I hope I have made myself very clear what are the degree of polynomials. Degree of the polynomials is the highest degree of the polynomial. So over here the highest degree was 2. Over here we have, in this terms we have two variables, so we have to calculate the degree of the polynomial. So 2 plus 2 gives you 4. So here the highest degree of polynomial is 4. Now let's move further. Types of polynomial. Now there are two types of polynomial. First is based on number of terms, and second, it is based on degree. That is the reason why I have made myself clear what is the degree over here. Now coming to based on number of terms. Number of terms. If number of terms is 1, then it is monomial. If there are two number of terms, then it is binomial. And if there are three number of terms, then it is trinomial. Let us make it very clear with the example. Monomial. 3x is monomial. 4x is monomial. 1 again is a monomial. It is a constant polynomial, but it is a monomial. There are only one terms, one degree. Okay, one terms, 3x, 4x and 1. Now coming to binomial. The example of binomial is 2x plus 3. There are two terms, 1 and 2. One more example, 4y plus 3. Again, two terms, 1 and 2. So it is a binomial. Now coming to trinomial. The example is 3x square plus 4x plus y. This is my trinomial because there are three terms, 1, 2 and 3. One more example, 5x plus 6x square plus 7. Again three terms, 1, 2, 3. So this is a trinomial. Now from the word itself we can make out that is mono means 1, bi means 2 and tri means 3. So if you are stating it as monomial, it will consist only one term. If you are trying to say binomial, then it will consist of two terms. And if you are trying to say trinomial, then it will consist of 1, 2 and 3 terms. I hope I have made myself clear, very clear, types of polynomial based on number of terms. Now coming to types of polynomials based on degree. Now here we have, if degree is 1, we say it as linear polynomial. If degree is 2, we say it as quadratic polynomial. And if degree is 3, we state it as cubic polynomial. I don't again have to explain what is degree, what are degrees, because I've already explained it to you. What is the degree and what should be the highest degree. So over here, linear means 1. If I am writing any example, it can consist of 1 term, 2 term, 3 terms and multiple terms. But make sure the degree is only 1. So when I am writing an example 3x, 3x over here. It is a single, it is a monomial. It is a single term, it is a monomial. But the degree is 1. So it is a linear polynomial. Again, 4x plus 1. There are two terms. You can have two terms, you can have three terms. But make sure the degree should be, the degree of the variable should be 1. So here the degree of variable is, nothing is given, we assume it as 1. It is 1. So it is a linear polynomial. Now coming to quadratic with the same example. 3x square. When I write it 2, it becomes quadratic. So this is a quadratic polynomial. Same, even if there are two terms, but the degree, highest degree should be 2. The highest degree over here is 2. So it is a quadratic polynomial. And again I am writing the same example, 3x cube. So here the degree is 3. The degree of variable x is 3. So it is a cubic polynomial. Same over here, 4x cube. Plus 1. Over here there are two terms. It doesn't matter two terms, three terms or single term. But the degree, highest degree should be 3. And here highest degree is 3. So it is a cubic polynomial. Now let us make it very much clear by solving the practice set 2.1, question number 9. Here they have, in question number 9 it is written, the question is trying to say write the appropriate polynomials in the boxes, and they have given you the free polynomials, and on the side they have given you boxes for linear polynomial, quadratic polynomial, cubic polynomial, and on the left right side they have given you binomial, trinomial and monomial. So the questions are, the given polynomials are x plus 7, x square, x cube plus x square plus x plus 5, 2x square plus 5x plus 10, x cube plus 9, and last but not the least, 3x square plus 5x. Now these are the polynomials. We have to decide it, we have to differentiate it based on terms and based on degree. Now when coming to based on terms, so I am writing here monomial, binomial and trinomial. As you know, I have already told you, if there is only one term, so it is monomial. As you can see over here, this is the only polynomial with one term, so it falls under monomial. Again, there are no such examples for monomial. Coming to binomial. Binomials means there should be two terms. So here you can see there are two terms, 1 and 2. So x plus 7 is binomial. Again, x cube plus 9 is binomial. And last, 3x square, because there are two terms, 1, 2, 3x square plus 5x is again a binomial. And when coming to trinomial, there is only one example. Here there are four terms, we want only three terms, and three terms is in this example 2x square plus 5x plus 10. Now coming to the next step, which is based on degree, linear polynomial quadratic polynomial and cubic polynomial. Over here, linear polynomial, the degree should be 1. Linear means the degree should be 1. As you can see in the first example, the highest degree is 1. So x plus 7 is the linear polynomial. Over here, the highest degree is 2. So highest degree is 2 means it is the quadratic polynomial. So it will fall under quadratic polynomial. Over here, 3, 4 terms are there, but the highest degree is 3, 2, 1. The highest degree is 3. So it will fall under cubic polynomial. So x cube plus x square plus x plus 5. Next example, the highest degree over here, it is 2, this is 1 and this is 0. Highest degree is 2. So 2 means quadratic. So it will fall under quadratic polynomial, which is 2x square plus 5x plus 10. Next, x cube plus 9. The highest degree is 3. 3 means cubic. So it will fall under cubic polynomial. X cube plus 9. And last example, 3x square plus 5x. The highest degree is 2. So it will fall under quadratic polynomial. Sorry, I don't have space over here. So I am writing it over here down, which is 3x square plus 5x. I hope I have made it very much clear what are the polynomials and what are the types of polynomials. I hope you enjoyed this lecture. Thank you very much for your time.